This video is produced by Varun, part of Technical Marketing Engineering team. Please note that in this video, we are going to show the HA configuration of two DD9910 models. The procedure is same for DD9410 as well. In this video, we are going to demonstrate how to configure high availability between two DD9910 models. Here are the two controller nodes of DD9910. All the cache disks from both the controllers need to be removed. Please note that we need to have a dedicated enclosure FS240 to configure HA in both DD9910 and DD9410 models, which should have required cache disks. Make sure the dual path cables are laid between the two controllers and the FS240 enclosure as shown in the figure. In slot 7, use quad port 25 GBE NIC on both the controller as HA internode communication interface. Port number 3 and 4 are used for RDMA, remote direct memory access, and 1 and 2 are used for heartbeat and sync. Log in into the CLI of primary node and perform net show hostname to check the hostname of the system. Perform ifconfig and make sure VF99 does not exist. Perform both the commands on the secondary node as well. On the primary node, execute the command disk show state to check the status of the disk. By default, all the cache disks are placed in enclosure 1 on both the models, whereas for HA, the cache disks are on enclosure 2, which is FS240 DAE. Please note, this video is captured from the testing environment. This is why there are more cache disks that are supported by the system. The supported number of cache disks is 10. Similarly, while performing the same command on the secondary node, all the cache disks are shown as foreign disks. Check the status of the file system on the primary node. It should be disabled and shut down. If not, disable it. In this case, it is already disabled. Similarly, on the secondary node, the file system does not exist because it is a new system. Upload the HA license on the primary node if it is not already applied on the system. Now we'll run HA precheck peer secondary node name or IP to check the status of all the required components. If any one of the component statuses is not passed, fix the issue before configuring the HA. To create HA, perform HA create peer secondary node name, which will ask for the confirmation to trust the certificate. As part of the configuration, the HA system name, local, and peer node hostname are set accordingly. Also, both the systems will be rebooted once the HA configuration is completed. Once the system is back online, log into the primary node CLI and perform HA status, which provides the status of the active and passive node. The state of the active node will display as degraded because it takes some time to update. Similarly, log into the secondary node and execute the same. Perform ifconfig to check the VF99, which is also configured as part of HA config. This concludes the video. Thanks for watching.